Welcome to the sixth lecture of course module Communication Engineering. So I hope that you must have gone through the previous all lectures because all the lectures are connected to each other. So please go through the all previous lectures. In the last lecture, we have already seen the demodulation of our AM wave, which is a single tone modulated wave using coherent modulation. We have already seen the quadrature null effect also. If there is a phase difference between the carrier that we have used at the receiver end and at the transmitter end, and that the phase difference is 90 degree, then generally the massive signal cannot be recovered and it is completely lost, which is called as the quadrature null effect. Now today we are going to see another topic, which is our amplitude modulation, but at this case the our massive signal will be a multi-tone signal. Okay, so we have to see the second case. In the first case we have seen that our massive signal was a single tone case, okay, in which we have taken MT equals to AM cos 2 pi FMT. So it was just consist of a single frequency component. Now we have to see, let us suppose that in this standard equation, okay, of amplitude modulation, let us suppose that this MT is not a our single tone case. It is not a single tone signal, but rather we are having a multi-tone signal. So I have already explained you what is multi-tone signal. So let us suppose that if we have any multi-tone signal MT, okay, whose spectrum, frequency spectrum is known to us. Let us suppose that this is the frequency spectrum of our multi-tone signal, okay? So its frequency spectrum is denoted by FM, MF, okay? And this is its typical frequency spectrum, okay? So here we can see that it is a multi-tone signal, and therefore it is having non-zero values for a frequency range between 0 to W, okay? So in this range, we are going to get a non-zero value of our Fourier transform. It is getting, we are getting a non-zero value. So that's why we are saying it is a consist of more than one frequency, and it is having a multi-tone, okay? It is having consist of multiple frequencies, okay? So it is a multi-tone signal, and because we are talking about the real signals, so obviously it will have its spectrum at the negative side also, and it will be same as the mirror image, okay, of the positive side. So we are getting this complete spectrum of our multi-tone signal, okay? And let us suppose that the multi-tone signal at frequency zero, its maximum value is equals to M0. So this is our multi-tone signal. So now instead of having single tone case, now this MT is having multi-tone case, okay? So what is known to us is the Fourier transform of the MT is known to us, okay? So if we want to calculate the Fourier transform of this equation, as I told you in the previous case, we have to expand this particular product term, okay? So this will be becoming AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KA MT multiplied with AC cos 2 pi FCT, okay? So that will be the term, and then we have to take the Fourier transform of this particular equation. So here I'm just going to use one of the property which is called as the modulation property. Okay, so what is that modulation property? Just you try to look at this. So in the modulation property, because if you expand this signal, we are going to get one of the product term, which is nothing but our MT multiplied with AC cos 2 pi FCT. So we are going to get the product of two time domain signals. Okay, we are going to get the two time domain product of the two time domain signals. So if we are having the product of two time domain signals, MT into CT, CT can be anything signal, but if in this case the CT is our carrier, so if we are having any signal RT which is equals to the product of the two signals, so if we wish to calculate the Fourier transform of this RT, which is nothing but the product of these two signal, then its Fourier transform RF will be same as the Fourier transform of the individual signals convolved together. Okay, this particular sign is representing the convolution operation. Okay, it is not the product. It is showing the convolution. Okay, convolution in the frequency domain. So here you can see that if the Fourier transform of this MT and the Fourier transform of CT is individually known, in that case, what we can do is we can directly calculate the Fourier transform of this RT, which is the product of MT and CT, by having this equations. Okay, so this RF will be same as MF, means the Fourier transform of MT convolved with the Fourier transform of our signal CT. Okay, so this is called as the modulation property. Okay, so in the communication terminology or even in the signal sense system, you will find that this property is called as modulation property. Okay, let us suppose if instead of having F, if we have taken, let us suppose R omega, and if it is denoted by M omega and C omega, then the only one factor 1 upon 2 pi will come into this equation. That's it. Okay, that will take care whether it is F or omega. So if it is omega, then 1 upon 2 pi factor will come into this particular equation. So one more thing that I would like to tell you, that let us suppose that if any signal whose Fourier spectrum MF is known, and if this is going to convolve with a delta function delta F minus FC, then this convolution is same as M F minus FC. Okay, so what does it mean if MF is convolved with a delta function F minus FC? So what does it mean? This is a delta function situated at F equals to FC. Okay, so basically the spectrum of MF is going to be shifted around FC. The meaning is that M F minus FC. The meaning is that the spectrum of M is going to be shifted around F equals to FC. Okay, it should be shifted around F equals to FC. This is the only thing that we have to take here. So whenever there is a convolution between like delta function and any known Fourier transform, this property can be used. If it is delta F plus FC, then this result would have been M F plus FC. Okay, so this is the two things that we have to use in this case. So if we take the Fourier transform of this particular equation, okay, this particular equation, then the Fourier transform will be, obviously we are going to get this term first, AC cos 2 pi FCT. So the Fourier transform of this is already known. There will be a two delta function. One is at F equals to FC and another at F plus F equals to minus FC, and whose magnitude will be equals to AC by 2. Now we have to write the Fourier transform for this product term. Okay, so we are going to get ACKA. Okay, ACKA, and there will be a term because of the known Fourier transform of cos 2 pi FCT. So cos 2 pi FCT will be having its Fourier transform equals to 1 upon 2 delta functions, right? Delta function F plus FC and F minus FC, this. Okay, so again, because it is empty, so what way we have to write? We have to write like KA AC by 2. Then in bracket, we can write it is MF convolved with 1 upon 2, and then either you can write 1 upon 2 over here, or you can write here. Okay, so that can be written as delta function F minus FC plus delta function F plus FC. Okay, and then we can use this particular property. I hope you must be able to clear what I'm saying is, I'm saying that this is MT into cos 2 pi FCT. So because it is a product in the time domain, we have to use this modulation property. So once you will calculate the Fourier transform of this particular equation, this will turn out to be like MF convolved with CF. Okay, and here the CF will be equals to 1 upon 2 delta F minus FC plus delta F plus FC. Okay, and then we have to use this property. Okay, you have to use this property. So once you will use this property, ultimately this results gives you M F minus FC plus M F plus FC. Okay, so we are going to get this particular Fourier transform. Okay, try to convince yourself that this Fourier transform you are going to get. Okay, it is very important. So we are going to get KA AC by 2 M F minus FC plus M F plus FC. So now you can see that previously, without modulation, our mass signal was having this particular Fourier transform. Okay, its frequency spectrum was like this. Okay, so it was central around our zero value. Okay, f equals to zero. So it was situated around f equals to zero. So now, due to the modulation, okay, due to the modulation, if you see here, this spectrum has to be shifted around f equals to fc and shifted around f equals to minus fc. So here you can see that we are having f equals to fc term. Okay, so here we have one delta function. Here you can see that in the equation we are having one delta function at f equals to fc whose magnitude is ac by 2. So here we have the delta function, okay, ac by 2 delta f minus fc. And now around this f equals to fc, this spectrum has to be shifted, okay, around this. So initially it was around f equals to 0. So here you can consider that this mf, okay, f minus 0 we can write. It means that it was situated around f equals to 0. Now it is situated around f equals to fc. So it is at f equals to fc, it will be shifted. Okay, so it is shifted version of that particular m. Okay, so obviously its higher point will be fc plus w. Okay, so it is here at fc plus w, and the lower frequency component will be at fc minus w. Okay, because it has to be shifted. Okay, similarly, we have to again make advance shift when f is equals to minus fc. Okay, so we have to make a left shift and we have to make a right shift. So again, it will be shifted around at f equals to minus fc. So here the highest frequency component will be minus fc plus w, and here it will be minus fc minus w. Okay, so this way again, we have another delta function at delta at f equals to minus fc. So here we have another delta function ac by 2 at f equals to minus fc. So again, you can again try to see and convince yourself we are going to get two delta functions. So we are having two delta functions at one point here, and another point is at this point. And we are going to make a shift, like first shift to the right shift at this location. So we have right shifted this spectrum. This particular spectrum has been right shifted, okay, around FC. And again, we have to make a left shift of this particular spectrum. So it is left shifted at this point around F equals to minus FC. So this way we are going to get this particular spectrum. Okay, similarly, any spectrum you can plot. Okay, any spectrum for any multi tone signal, we can plot our frequency spectrum. So remember that we have to use these two property. One is the modulation property, and second one is that if it is convolution with the any delta functions, then in frequency domain, the result will be the shifted version of the frequency spectrum of the masses signal around the FC or minus FC. Fine. So this way we are going to get our spectrum. So here you can see its magnitude, it is KAAC by 2, KAAC by 2. And we already know that it has its value at f equals to 0 equals to m naught. So it has to be multiplied with m naught. Okay, so it is multiplied with m naught. So this is how we can get our frequency spectrum. I told you that anything which is greater than the fc, that will be called as the upper side band. Okay, similarly, in the negative side, which is lower than the minus fc, will be our upper side band. So it is our upper side band, and this one is our lower side band. Again, we are having the lower side band. Now here you can see that if you talk about the bandwidth of our masses signal, so I told you that to calculate the bandwidth, we have to calculate the maximum frequency minus minimum frequency. Okay, we should have a certain range. Okay, so we have maximum frequency component W and minimum frequency component equals to zero. So W minus zero will give you the bandwidth of this masses signal equals to W. Okay, similarly, here we can calculate the bandwidth of the modulated signal. This is the spectrum of the modulated signal. So we have to calculate the bandwidth of the modulated signal. Okay, so that bandwidth will be the maximum frequency component to the minimum frequency component. So here it is FC plus W minus FC plus W. Okay, so FC, FC will be cancelled out. We are going to get 2W. You please do not bother about again that I have taken this minus this, okay, and here I have taken this minus this, okay. So you please remember that while calculating the bandwidth, you please only consider the positive frequency components, okay, only positive frequency, maximum positive frequency and minimum positive frequency. So the minimum value here, it is zero, okay. But in this case, after modulation, the maximum frequency component is fc plus w, and the minimum positive frequency component is fc minus w. So that's why we are calculating the frequency bandwidth in this way. Okay. So here its parameter is W. It is not 2W. Please do not confuse. Okay, so it is W. So this way we can calculate our bandwidth. Now we can again take a very simple example, like by taking MT, like a multi-tone signal in which we are having large amount of signal frequencies which is available in this case. I can also take a simple case in which the MT is just the summation of the two cosine functions. Okay, again it is a multi-tone signal because it is consist of more than one frequency. So we can take this case also, like MT equals to AAM 1 and cos 2 pi FM 1T plus AM 2 cos 2 pi FM 2T. The summation of the two cosine functions of different frequency and different amplitude. Okay, so again it becomes the multi-tone signal because we are having two different frequency components. Okay, it is consist of more than one frequency. So once we have this, then you can substitute the MT value into the standard expression of your AM. So once you will substitute this, again you can go on expanding this particular signal, and then again you can either follow the modulation property or you can expand the signal as we did in the case of single tone modulation, and then again you can find out this particular standard equation. Okay, so here is the standard equation that you are going to get, like AC cos 2 pi FCT plus mu 1 AC by 2, then cos 2 pi FC minus F1T MF1T cos 2 pi FC plus FM1T, okay, then mu 2 AC by 2 FC minus FM2T and FC plus FM2T. Okay, so this way we are going to get, and again what we have to do is it is very simple to get. Okay, just expand it and you just use the trigonometric formula, you will get this equation easy, because here we have KAAM1. Okay, KAAM1, so it is going to give you a modulation index mu1. Okay, and here we have KA multiplied with AM2. Okay, so it is going to give you modulation index mu2. So that's why we are writing here it is mu1 and here it is mu2, so that you don't confuse why it is mu1 and mu2. Okay, if it it has, let us suppose that AM and AM only, so we could have written like mu only because it is just giving you the same modulation index, but because here the amplitude of these two cosine functions are different, we are going to get the different modulation for different masses signals. So that's why I have written it as mu2 and mu1. Okay, so after doing this, just you have to calculate the Fourier transform of this equation. So I hope now you must be able to perform that. Okay, you can directly calculate Fourier transform because all are the cosine functions. So here you can see how many cosine functions we have: 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The total 5 cosine functions we have, it means that there will be 5 into 2, total 10 delta functions should be there of certain amplitudes. Okay, that we can easily understand from this equation. Okay, so if you compare with the masses signal, this is our masses signal, we have only two terms, so total 4 cosine, total 4 delta function will come into the spectrum, and here we are going to get the total 10 delta function in the modulated signal. Okay, so if you plot this delta function for the masses signal MF, okay, let us suppose that the AM1 is greater than the AM2. In that case, one delta function will come at FM1 and another delta function will come at FM2. Okay, so this amplitude will be AM1 by 2 and here the amplitude will be AM2 by 2. Similarly, another delta function will come at the mirror image. Okay, so this is the Fourier spectrum or frequency spectrum of the masses signal, which is a multi-tone signal because we are going to get the two frequency component. Fine. So this way we have the Fourier transform of our multi-tone signal. Now, for this particular modulated signal, we can again plot this signal. So as I told you that there will be a total 10 number of delta functions here. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total 10 number of delta function. One is at FC, okay. One is at FC, AC by 2 will be the magnitude. Then we are having another frequency component at FC plus FM1, then FC plus FM2. Similarly, at FC minus FM1, FC minus FM2. Okay, similarly, the mirror image you can plot and you can write this magnitude values accordingly. Okay, I hope it is very simple to do. Now you must be able to perform this. So this spectrum you can get. Okay, now we can see here is that the magnitude, like I have drawn some magnitude, is lesser than the other one, just based on the fact that if we consider that the AM2 is less than the AM1, okay, and in that case we can plot in this way. Okay, if it is same, then a similar height of delta function you can plot, so that you can take care of while plotting the delta functions. Okay, as for the given questions or problems, you have to do the things accordingly. Now again, you can calculate the like bandwidth. So here, if you calculate the bandwidth of, in this case, okay, the maximum frequency component is FM2 and minimum frequency component is FM1. So this bandwidth will be equals to FM2 minus FM1. That will be the bandwidth. Okay, this minus this. That will be the bandwidth, because the lower component is now FM1. But in this case, if you calculate the bandwidth of this particular signal, modulated signal, again the maximum frequency component is FC plus FM2, and the minimum frequency component is FC minus FM2. So this FC, FC will be cancelled out. We are going to get 2FM2. That will be the bandwidth of our this particular modulated signal. So I hope this discussion must be okay for you. You must be able to calculate the Fourier transform, and you will be able to plot this particular frequency spectrum. Now, one more thing that we have to look at is how to calculate the power requirement of a multi-tone case. Okay, so let us suppose, so this is the simplest example we can take, and we can calculate the power requirement for this AM signal in multi-tone case. So we have this particular equation, okay, of modulated signal. So now if you wish to calculate the component, power component, okay, so we can calculate the power component for each and every portion. Okay, so here you can see that we are having this component, again here we have these all components. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So for all these cosine functions, we can write the power value. This total power we can write, as I told you, the power value will be equals to, if this is AC, then it will become AC square by 2. Okay. Similarly, this is mu 1 AC by 2. So it will come twice, because there is two cosine function, one at FC minus FM1 and another is at FC plus FM1. So this will be equals to, again, mu 1 square AC square by 2, AC square by 8. Again, for this, we have to write 8. Again, for this, again, it is mu 2, so just to take care of that, we have written mu 2 square AC square by 8. And again, for this term, we have to write mu 2 square AC square by 8. So that we can write easily, okay, that we can write easily. So now this is our the total power. Now if we got this total power, okay, for all these 5 cosine terms, now what we can do is we can simplify it further. So AC square by 2 is a common, so we can take out this AC square by 2, then 1 will come over here. Then here you can see that if we take out AC square by 2 outside, then after adding this 2, 1, this 8 will become 4. And after adding this 2, 1, this 8 in the denominator will become 4. So after taking 1 by 2 common, it will become in the denominator, the factor 2 will come. And here we are going to get the mu 1 square. And here we are going to get the mu 2 square. Okay. So I hope this must be clear how this second step will come. Okay. So after that, AC square by 2 is actually nothing but the carrier power. Okay. It is reflecting the carrier power. This is the carrier component. Fine. So we are going to get the AC square by 2. So AC square by 2 is nothing but our carrier power. I have written it as a carrier power. Now I have just replaced mu 1 square plus mu 2 square is equals to mu 2 mu t square. Okay, I have just replaced by this. Okay, so pt is equals to pc 1 plus mu t square by 2, where mu t is the total modulation index. Okay, mu t is nothing but the total modulation index. Fine. So how it can be written over here is mu t is equals to root over mu 1 square plus mu 2 square. Okay, this is the total modulation index of this particular signal. Okay, for this particular multi-tone case. Okay, so here we can generalize one thing, that let us suppose if we have added one more cosine function, okay, and because of that there is another modulation index mu 3. Okay, so this total modulation index would have become mu 1 square plus mu 2 square plus mu 3 square. So what we can generalize is, in the case of modulation, multi-tone modulation, if there are number of cosine terms that have been added, then based on that, this can be generalized as mu1 square plus mu2 square plus mu3 square plus mu4 square plus dash dash dash. Okay, that will be the generalization of the total modulation index. So sometimes in the problems, it comes like there are total four cosine functions of different frequencies has been added to generate a multi-tone signal. And then they will ask you, for this particular case of multi-tone modulation, calculate the total modulation index. So you have to calculate the individual mu1, mu2, mu3, and mu4, and then you have to calculate the total by following this particular formula. Now, one more thing I could write is that, as we know that this total power can be written as the total current which is flowing through the circuit. So IT square into R, okay? So it is the total power delivered to the load. If the load is R, then it will be written as IT square into R. Okay, similarly, the carrier power PC can also be written as the carrier current which is flowing, okay? The current which is flowing due to only presence of the carrier. So it is IC square into R, okay? So now this RR can be canceled out. So this PT equation, the total power equation in terms of modulation, total modulation index and the carrier power can also be written as in the terms of total current, okay? Total current due to the modulation, which will be equals to the carrier current, okay? Root over 1 plus mu2 square by 2. So I hope this equation must be clear, how to get these two equations. So sometimes questions may come like in terms of modulation current, okay? It may come like a modulation current. That time we need to understand how this can be answered, right? Now we have to look at the one of the very important term, which is modulation efficiency, okay? So how this modulation efficiency is defined, okay? So modulation efficiency is a terminology which is very important, okay? And it is actually defined as the total sideband power, okay? Total sideband power divided by total power. So you remember that in the previous lecture, I also told you that this entire term, okay, this entire term is the total sideband power, because one of them is like two of them is upper sideband and the two of them is another two of them is lower sideband. Means a term like FC plus FM1 and FC plus FM2 will give you upper sideband power, and the term FC minus FM2 and FC minus FM1 will be giving you lower sideband power. So what we can say that the addition of the two is giving you upper sideband, and the addition another two is giving you lower sideband. So basically this summation of the lower sideband power plus upper sideband power will give you the total sideband powers. Okay, so this entire term, okay, the addition of this entire term is giving you the sideband power, and this is the carrier power. This is the carrier power, and this is our total power. Okay. So basically what we can see is the total power is consist of carrier power plus total sideband power. Okay. So the modulation efficiency is actually defined as what is the total sideband power divided by the total power. Okay. Total sideband power divided by the total power. So this ratio is going to give you the modulation efficiency, right? So modulation index is different thing and modulation efficiency is different thing, okay? So this modulation efficiency is going to tell you that how much power is being effectively utilized in sending the massive signal, okay? Because we can see that this actually comes out to be PSB upon PT. PSB means power in sidebands. So in the previous lectures, we have already seen it actually, okay? This particular sideband power, even from this equation itself, you can see that this PC, it will become, if you expand it, you will get like PC plus PC mu T square by 2. Okay. So here we have written that PC mu T square by 2 is nothing but your sideband power. So here I have just written PC mu square by 2 in the case of single tone modulation when we did it. Okay. So PC mu square by 2. Again, we have to write the total power. So total power is nothing but PC 1 plus mu square by 2. So it is PC 1 plus mu square by 2. Okay. So this PC PC will be cancelled out, and we are going to get this equation mu square upon 2 plus mu square. So this equation is for our modulation efficiency, mu square upon 2 plus mu square. Now from here itself, we can calculate the different modulation efficiency. Okay, so at different values of mu, obviously it is depending on the modulation index. So for the different modulation index, we are going to get the different modulation efficiency. So from here itself, you can see that when the modulation index, which is whose maximum value is equals to 1, this modulation efficiency that we are going to get is 0.33. Okay, it means that only 33.33 power, okay, 33.33 percentage of the power is going to be used in the side bands, okay, and all rest of the powers like 67% is wasted only in sending the carrier. Okay, this is already I have discussed. Okay, this thing I have already discussed in my previous lectures, in which I have shown you that the 33.33% of the power is only being utilized in sending the sidebands, and the rest of the power will be wasted in sending the carrier itself. Okay, that's why we are saying that it's this EM modulation scheme is not power efficient. Okay, because its power is actually wasted in sending the carrier itself. Okay, only 33% is utilized in sending the message signal, because message is actually available only in the sidebands. It is not available in the carrier part. Okay, so you can see this one. Okay, this is our carrier part. So within the carrier part, there is no message. Okay, the message signal is available only in the sidebands, because FC plus FM1. So FM1 is present over here, FM2 is present over here. Okay, similarly in the lower sideband, FM1 is present, FM2 is present. Okay, so this power is sideband power only consists of the message signal, but the carrier component doesn't consist any signal, any message component. So it is wasted in only in we are wasting most of the power only in sending the carrier. Okay, which is not the effective utilization of the carrier signal. Okay, means power. Okay, total power. So now one more thing that we have to take care is that here we are sending both the sidebands, upper sideband as well as the lower sideband. Both the sidebands have been sent in the case of conventional AM. Okay, and that side is taking more bandwidth. Okay, the bandwidth is equals to 2 FM2. Okay, 2W in the previous case if you have seen. Okay, so basically it is not also bandwidth efficient, because in the subsequent lecture I will tell you that just sending one of the sideband is also sufficient, and we will be able to get back the original message signal. Either we can send only upper sideband or we can send the lower sideband. So just sending one of the sideband is sufficient. So there is no need of sending both the sidebands. Okay, so after just reducing one of the, or eliminating one of the sideband, okay, we can reduce both bandwidth requirement of the modulated signal as well as the power requirement, that we will be seeing in the subsequent lectures. Okay, so I hope this must be clear. So if you have any query, any doubt, okay, regarding this lecture, you can drop me a message in the comment box. So in the next lecture, I will be coming up with the generation technique of the EM signal. So thank you for watching. Stay connected. I will be discussing the next topic in the next lecture. So thank you.